Today, I am explaining Euclid division lemma. Euclid is a Greek mathematician. He is known as father of geometry. He wrote the book The Elements. It containing 13 parts. This Euclid division lemma, in the 7th part of The Elements. Here, take two positive integers. For example, 5 and 3. If 5 is divided by 3, 3 once 3, we get remainder 2 and quotient 1. So, it is written as 3 into 1 plus 2. Take another number 6 is divided by 3, 3 2 is 6 plus 0. Another number 7 divided by 3, 3 2 is 6 and remainder 1. Take 8 is divided by 3, 3 2 is 6 and remainder 2. Take 9 is divided by 3, 3 3 is 9, the remainder is 0. And 10, 3 3 is 9, the remainder 1. Take another number 11, 3 3 is 9, remainder 2. And so on. If any number divided by 3, the remainders are 0, 1 and 2. Take another number 2. If any number divided by 2, we get the remainders 0 and 1 only. If any number divided by 3, we get remainders as 0, 1 and 2 only. Any number divided by 4, we get the remainders 0, 1, 2 and 3. If any number divided by 5, we get remainders 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 only. If A, B are any two numbers, A is divided by B. Some quotient is there, remainder. It is written as A equal to BQ plus R. If we divide by 5, the remainder starts from 0, ends with less than 5, that is 4. If a number divided by 4 starts from 0 and ends with less than 4, that is 3. So, we divided A by B, then we get A equal to BQ plus R. Here, R is a remainder. The value of R ends with less than R and start with 0, that is 0 less than or equal to R less than B. So A equal to BQ plus R, the limits of R is 0 less than or equal to R less than B. Here given two positive integers a and b. The unique pair of integers q and r, there is just a equal to bq plus r, 0 less than or equal to r less than b. It is a Euclid division lemma. So now I am writing the definition of Euclid division lemma. Given positive integers, a and b, there exist the unique pair of integers q and r satisfying a equal to bq plus r, here 0 less than or equal to r less than b. Take the positive integers, any positive integers a and b. If a is divided by b, there exist unique pair of integers. These are the unique, the q and r unique. These are the integers. The unique pair of integers satisfying a equal to bq plus r. Here r is remainder, q is quotient. The limits of the remainder 0 less than or equal to r less than b. That means start with 0 and ends with less than b. Now I am explaining one example. Show that square of any positive integer in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1 by using Euclid division lemma. Take an integer, any integer. Let a be an integer. If a is divided by 3, divided by 3, we get a equal to 3q plus r, 0 less than or equal to r less than 3, 0 less than or equal to r less than 3, that is r equal to 0, 1, 0 and 1, also 2, 0, 1, 2. Here start with 0, ends with less than 0, r is an integer, so 0, 1, 2. Now we have to prove square of the positive integer. Square of the positive integer, we take a, so we take a square, so squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. A square equal to 3q plus r whole square. We kept in mind the limits of r, 0 less than or equal to r less than 3. That means r equal to 0, 1, 2. Here r, right? R, the limits of r is 0 less than or equal to r less than 3. That means 0, 1 and 2. It is in the form of a plus b whole square. A square 9q square plus 2ab, 2 into 3, 6q into r, 6qr plus b square r square. Here the values of r is 0, 1 and 2. Case 1, r equal to 0. then a square equal to 9 q square plus 6 q into 0, here r equal to 0, 6 q into 0 plus 0 square, 0 square is 0, 6 q into 0 is 0, so a square equal to 9 q square. In this problem, we have to prove square of this number, that means a square, is in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. Here, we get 9q square. 9q square is written as 3 into 3q square. 3 into 3q square. If 3q square equal to m, that is 3m. A square equal to 3m. Here, m equal 3q square. And take r equal to 1, case 2, r equal to 1, then a square equal to 9 q square plus 6 q into 1 plus 1 square, 6 q into 1 plus 1 square. That equal to 9q square plus 6q into 1, 6q plus 1. Here, in 9q square and 6q, 3 is the common factor. Here, there is no 3. So, you take common factors 3, then 3q square plus 2q plus 1. If it is m, it is in the form of 3m plus 1. That is equal to 3m plus 1. Here, m equal to 3q square plus 2q. The value of r, another one, 2. Case 3. R equal to 2. Then substitute r equal to 2. A square equal to 9q square plus 6q into 2 plus 2 square. A square equal to 9q square plus 6q into 2 plus 2 square. That equal to 9q square plus 6 to 12, 12q plus 2 square 4. Here, 9q square plus 12q has 3 as common factor. In 4, here 3 is also in 4. 4 is written as 3 plus 1. So, 3 has common factor. It is written as, a square is written as 9q square plus 12q plus 3 plus 1. In this part, 3 is the common factor. That is equal to 3 into 3q square plus 3 4 12. 3q 4q plus 3 1 3 plus 1. If it is m, it is in the form of 3m plus 1. That is equal to 3m plus 1. Here, m equal to 3q square plus 4q plus 1. So, the values of r is 0, 1 and 2. In the case 1, we take r equal to 0. We get a square in the form of 3m. In the second case, take r equal to 1. So, we get a square in the form of 3m plus 1. In the third case, r equal to 2. We get a square is in the form of 3m plus 1. From the three cases, case 1, case 2 and case 3, a square in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1 or 3m plus 1 by case 1, 2 and 3, a square is in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. Hence, any positive integer a, a square is the square of any positive integer is in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. Hence the problem.